This is Vedatri. Welcome you to another session of Online Legal Awareness. I have been a practicing legal professional in the Honorable Supreme Court of India and the Honorable High Court of Calcutta and currently working as law faculty in IIIJS under the University of Engineering and Management, Kolkata. I'm here to make yourselves a little more aware of your basic legal rights as Indian citizens. In my previous video on anticipatory bail, all that you need to know, I have already discussed about the concept of anticipatory bail and the procedure to apply for such bail and your option if such bail is rejected. In this video, I will talk about the procedure after the court has granted you the anticipatory bail and what are your rights and the cancellation grounds for such bail and most importantly the basic expenditure that might incur. So let us start with the procedure that follows after the grant of the anticipatory bail. You have to visit the police station along with your friend or your relative who you want to be your surety. That is compulsory. Whenever the court is granting you an anticipatory bail, this is the only option that is left to you. Whenever they give you a date, whenever they call you to the police station, you have to go there along with a friend and a relative who shall act as your surety. Both of you have to sign the bail bond in the police station itself and finally pay the amount that has been fixed by the court. Next, let us talk about what are your rights when the anticipatory bail has been granted to you. Of course, by this time you must know that the police officer, even if there is an FIR filed against you or there is a complaint of any cognizable offense against you, the police will not be able to arrest you. However, this comes with a small disclaimer. That is, if you do not follow or if you fail to follow any conditions given in the bail bond that you signed, remember the one that you signed in the police station there. If you do not follow those conditions, then the court would take back the bail. That is, it will cancel the bail and then the court may also direct for an arrest. Then no one will be able to save you, not even your lawyer. Next, let us talk about the grounds of cancellation of an anticipatory bail. Now, there are no such specific provisions given in the CRPC that tells you about, okay, these are the grounds on which your anticipatory bail will be cancelled, but it is completely upon the discretion of the court in concern. If the court feels that it has to cancel your bail for meeting the ends of justice, then it has to. And other than that, of course, if you fail to follow any of the conditions in your bail bond, then also your bail shall stand cancelled. After knowing all this, let me give you a small estimate of the expenditure that you might plan ahead if you are applying for an anticipatory bail. Since appointing a good lawyer is a must in application of an anticipatory bail, it is important that the cost is somewhere around 25,000 to 30,000. Of course, it will depend upon the sincerity of the case and the skill of the lawyer. I hope you found this information useful. Do tune in to our channel, the channel for UEM, for other questions and other videos on such practical topics. And do comment your feedbacks and your questions if you have any or any suggestions. And we would be happy to get back to you. Thank you for your patient hearing. Take care.